Let's mold in the Central Committee. Let's cringe in the Central Committee. Let's bog in the Central Committee right now.
This is the real cancel culture.
I don't want the state of Tennessee teaching my daughters about sex and lifestyle changes. The state of Tennessee is not allowed to teach my daughters Christian values that I think are important and they should learn, so I teach those at home. And so if those are not a part of the school curriculum, I don't see how LGBTQ and other issues and social lifestyle should be a part of the curriculum. And so what this bill simply seeks to do is to limit that so that neither side has an unfair advantage over the other regarding what's being taught in our schools to our children.
Six ayes and three nays.
You're on the full end.
I don't want the state of Tennessee teaching my daughters about sex and lifestyle changes. The state of Tennessee is not allowed to teach my...
Now, you may superficially think that argument makes sense. Well, why should schools be teaching children about sex stuff? They're supposed to be there to learn. They're not supposed to be there to learn about sex stuff. They're there to learn about the ones and the twos. They're there to learn that George Washington cut down a cherry tree and Abraham Lincoln never told a lie. They're also there to learn that it was the war of Northern aggression. Okay? That's what they're there to learn. They're there to learn that America's number one. They're not there to learn about this gay stuff. They're not there to learn about slavery the way it was. That'll make them hate their country. You want to teach them about the Trail of Tears? They're going to hate their country. They need to learn to love their country no matter what. Now, why do we want to teach children and people as they grow up into puberty about sex stuff? Because that kind of behavior has risks. That kind of behavior can lead to people getting pregnant in their teens, transmission of sexually transmitted diseases. It can lead to a lack of understanding of the processes going on in a person's body. And quite frankly, people begin to have sexual urges as they go through puberty. So we need to educate children about their own bodies, about the processes, so that they don't engage in that risky behavior and harm themselves and others, that they learn about other people and what's going on with them, so it's not a they aren't mystified by it. And we need to teach them what is appropriate and inappropriate behavior in regards to sexual activity and sexual attention and sexual contact. We teach people about consent. We teach people to respect one another. We teach people facts about their own body and the people around them. And we should teach people about the different types of sexualities that occur naturally so that they are not bigoted and harmful toward one another, so that they don't hate themselves because they're different, that they recognize that there's a lot of different ways to build a family, building empathy, educating, and reducing harm. That's why we teach people sex ed. And when you don't teach people sex ed, do you know what you get? A huge increase in teenage pregnancy and unwanted pregnancy. Vastly increased rates of sexually transmitted diseases. And, believe it or not, higher rates of teen sex, period. So their stick your head in the sand strategy makes things worse. Now, this reveals an important point about the differences between what conservatives believe and what the rest of us believe. Conservatives don't send you to education so that you can learn critically and learn from history. They educate you to demonstrate moral values. They don't want you to look back on history and compare it to today and say, oh, they made that mistake back then. We are doing this behavior now. That analogizes. We should change. No, change! My name's Bruce Griffey. I'm a representative. I don't want any change. And this bill, Republicans banning books that mention LGBTQ people. Banning books. I thought with Trump, the Republicans were pro-LGBT. I was told that by a lot of dumb fucks online. But here they are, banning books that merely mention the verifiable fact that there are people who identify, as LGBTQ. U.S. history class be like, America freed the slaves, America killed the Nazis, America loved MLK. And, you know, the one thing that you'll see about conservatives is they're constantly complaining, they're constantly whining about cancel culture. They're constantly complaining that we want to change history. But that's not the only thing. The real cancel culture is conservatives. The anti-cancel culture Republican Party is trying to cancel OnlyFans. GOP rep Paul Gosar. You guys remember Paul Gosar? Whose own family endorsed his opponent, wants the DOJ to investigate OnlyFans for online prostitution. Now, chat, let's take a moment here. I want to remind you of one of my favorite ads against Paul Gosar. You've seen it a couple times. Check this. This is one of my favorite ads.
Paul Gosar, the congressman, isn't doing anything to help rural America.
Paul's absolutely not working for his district.
If they care about health care, they care about their children's health care, they would hold him to account. If they care about jobs, they would hold him to account.
If he actually cared about people in rural Arizona, I bet he'd be fighting for Social Security.
They dropped the new ones?
For better access to health care. I bet he would be researching what is the most insightful water policy to help the environment of Arizona sustain itself and be successful.
And he's not listening to you, and he doesn't have your interests at heart. My name is Tim Gosar.
David Gosar.
Grace Gosar.
Joan Gosar.
Gaston Gosar.
Jennifer Gosar.
Paul Gosar is my brother.
My brother.
And I endorse Dr. Brill.
Dr. Brill.
Wholeheartedly endorse Dr. David Brill for Congress.
I'm Dr. David Brill, and I approve this message.
There's another one, chat.
None of this is pleasant for any of us.
It's horrible to have to do this.
To speak up against my brother, it brings sadness.
Of course, Brill lost.
This isn't just about Paul.
Of course, Brill lost.
Their family.
I think my brother has traded a lot of the values we had at our kitchen table.
I couldn't be quiet any longer, nor should any of us be.
We got to stand up for our good name. This
what
is
do private investigators do?
It's
bad
intervention
shit. They
time.
Suck.
And intervention time means that you go to vote and you go to vote Paul out. My name is Tim Gosar.
My name is Jennifer Gosar.
Gaston Gosar.
Joan Gosar.
Grace Gosar.
David Gosar.
Paul Gosar is my brother.
My brother.
My brother. And I endorse Dr. Brill.
Dr. Brill.
Dr. Now, Brill. Chat, you would think with a devastating ad like that, you would lose, right? But here's the thing, Republicans don't care. And I don't mean Republican politicians, I mean Republican voters, okay? Republican voters have been trained that if it has a D next to its name, it's bad. And these Republicans, the anti-cancel culture Republican Party is trying to cancel OnlyFans. And somebody just posted something, that would be a slippery slope, I think you mean, right into making online sex and sexting illegal. Can you fucking imagine? Of course. And another person said, Gray Haster said, well, Mike, they need to cancel OnlyFans. They can't help themselves. They can't have temptation. If OnlyFans exists, they could all become Matt Gaetz. That's exactly right. And that is also the logic of the Atlanta shooter. They were down. He went and shot up all those massage parlors and those women that work there because they were tempting him. And he had to destroy the temptation. It wasn't that he had to exercise control over himself. It's that he had to destroy all the temptations of that were around him. Arizona Rep. Paul Gosar paints himself as a free speech advocate, but he'd never seen a sex worker he didn't want to censor. This week, Gosar, the GOP author of the Stop Censorship Act of 2020, penned a letter begging Attorney General Merrick Garland to shut down OnlyFans and investigate the porn platform for violating the Mann Act. Known as the White Slave Law, the 1910 law forbids paying to transport women over state lines for prostitution. Gosar falsely believes that on this site, individuals could advertise their willingness to travel across state lines for illegal or immoral activities, and the platform providing publicity for these individuals appears to subsidize and capitalize off this travel. It's worth investigating this issue further. To prosecute OnlyFans, Garland would have to prove the company intended users to organize prostitution over state lines, but OnlyFans has done its best to make it impossible to arrange prostitution services on the site. OnlyFans goes out of its way to prevent users from even attempting to facilitate in-person sex work. They forbid users to even direct messaging about prostitution fantasies. OnlyFans even blocks performers and fans from typing the words meet or meeting in direct messages. If I wanted to meet a fan for coffee, I couldn't even discuss it on OnlyFans. I would have to ask a follower to tweet me and reply to them on Twitter with the message, "Can we meet for coffee?" Gosar cites anecdotal reports about prostitution, child exploitative material, and illegal sexual coercion, where performers upload their IDs before posting content on OnlyFans. Gosar purposely describes everything from coercion to child exploitative material to illicit images of sex trafficking, but he fails to cite a single data-driven account of sex trafficking or child abuse on OnlyFans. You can't say the same about Facebook or Instagram. The National Council for Missing and Exploited Children accuses Facebook and Instagram of reporting 20 million child sex abuse images in 2020, more than any other company. If he really cared about the abuse, Gosar would target Facebook and Instagram. Right now, he's targeting OnlyFans, while letting Facebook and Instagram off the hook. It's the equivalent to a local food inspector being called to shut down a clean restaurant while letting a dirty chain restaurant stay open with no consequences. Of course, prostitution differs from child abuse. An escort has nothing in common with a child abuser, and performers don't use OnlyFans to sell prostitution services. Gosar paints OnlyFans performers as prostitutes and prostitutes as child abusers to conflate all adult performers as depraved miscreants. He aims to create an environment where lawmakers will criminalize consenting adults for producing pornography. Gosar's assault comes amid a new panic about pornography. First, the New York Times collaborated with a homophobic church to paint all Pornhub users as sex traffickers and criminals. Then Utah tried to pressure phone manufacturers to block porn on adults' phones. After 4 years of insisting freedom of speech is under attack by the left! During the Trump era, Republicans are back to policing American sexuality and censoring porn stars. That's what I just showed you, chat. I just showed you it. Gosar would deny this. He claims he's protecting victims. The protection of vulnerable people from coercion of illegal, immoral sexual activity should be a priority of your department, Gosar writes. The keywords are immoral sexual activity. He wants Garland's Department of Justice to treat acts deemed immoral the same as criminal activity. Of course, the Justice Department lacks authority over enforcing morality. They enforce laws. It's easy to dismiss Gosar. His letter didn't even go viral. He's a cartoon character, but cartoons can cause grave damage. If we don't pay attention, Gosar and his ilk could illegalize certain types of sexuality, giving the Justice Department the right to police what consenting adults do in their bedrooms. They're already doing that with trans people. They're banning people from getting medical care because they're trans. They're going to end... They made it legal for medical providers to refuse to provide medical attention, not just gender-affirming care, but all care to trans people because of moral objections. What kind of morality tells you that if someone comes in hurt and sick and suffering, that you could deny them care because of who they are? The followers of Jesus Christ, whose most famous parable is "He without sin cast the first stone," who walked around and washed the feet of prostitutes and sinners, they're going around and telling people to refuse to provide health care to sick and injured trans people. It's easy to dismiss Gosar as a Trumpian blowhard whose own family hates him. But we live in dangerous times. If we learned anything from the Trump era, it's that the impossible can happen. A reality star can become president. And if we aren't careful, pornography could be a crime. Scream now before it's too late. If you think you're in a blue state and therefore you're safe, you're not. The Republican Party under George W. Bush was this close to getting a constitutional amendment banning gay marriage. This close. We do politics here every morning starting at 10 a.m. 10 a.m. Eastern, 7 a.m. Pacific. You can watch us here on Twitch. We're the morning guy, the morning politics guy, politics frogs in every single day, same time, 10 a.m., day in, day out. And we carry you through your morning and early afternoon politics needs. And if you need more, Mike from PA, we have a YouTube channel. We talked about suburbs, the My Pillow guy, Ted Cruz. We talked about DSA. Amazing. Making fun of Tim Pool. Amazing. Look at all of these amazing videos. Get in there, watch them. We have me on Twitter. You got to follow me on Twitter, chat. I'm at 20,614 subs. That means I got like 40 followers on Twitter in the last day. You can do better than that. You can do better than that. Go follow us on Twitter. And of course, join the Discord, where we have an incredible community of left-wing streamers We have Left Wing Community. We talk about the stream. We talk about politics. There's gaming content. It's a really awesome, supportive place. Direct action, mutual aid, and you can just let off some steam. And also, you can help produce the show. One of the things I do is I look at the links that are put into the news content suggestions chat room on the Discord. Join the Discord, come hang out, and maybe what you want me to talk about will be part of the next show.